We went to the doctor for an ear infection. But he sent us for some lab work, and the lab work came back that Garrett had some abnormalities in his blood work. And just from the tourniquet being on his arm, he had a soft tissue hematoma, which is a really big, deep bruise from his elbow to his armpit. At 9 months old, that's pretty alarming for a mom to see that on their little one. And so an immediate phone call went back to the doctor, and that's when they sent us down to Iowa City. They did some additional blood work, and it came back that Garrett had something called von Willebrand's disease.
I would describe von Willebrand's disease as your blood is not able, it does not have the agents to clot.
He lacks the sticky stuff, or the cement or glue that holds a blood clot together. Von Willebrand's disease happens in 1 to 100 to 1 in 1,000 people. And the reason why the range is so wide is because there's a lot of people that have von Willebrand's disease that don't even know that they have it. There was a research study going on at the University of Iowa hospitals, and they would test the whole family to see who else maybe had von Willebrand's, because von Willebrand's disease is hereditary. And through the testing, we found out that Garrett's dad has von Willebrand's disease.
It was good for me to find out that I had it as well as a child, and looking back, could see that some of the conditions I had, if I had known that I had it at the time, would have changed.
In addition to Garrett's von Willebrand's disease, through the years of looking at treatments and trying to figure out why Garrett was still bleeding, we found out through bone marrow biopsies and additional blood testing and genetic testing that Garrett also has 2 non-specific platelet disorders. And then we found out that Garrett has a genetic disorder, it's fairly uncommon, called GATA1. So Garrett is a really unique case, and it's not an easy case to treat. And the hematology team have just endlessly and tirelessly worked towards getting answers. Von Willebrand's disease is not something that will go away. This is something he will have for a lifetime. He has different therapies that we do. At times he's on prolonged steroid therapy, and he also does infusions at home. He now has a port in his chest, but the infusions that we do at home are an IV infusion that I've learned how to do. And Garrett's also been part of an ongoing research study that every year when we come down for his comprehensive clinic, they draw blood work from him. And that is to be part of the national research study so that hopefully we can learn more about von Willebrand's disease and bleeding disorders.
It's a problem for Garrett with his blood not clotting. He has to be careful in what he does as far as not injuring himself.
I've been a competitive dancer for 3 years. When I get frustrated and mad and angry because of all the bleeding disorders that I have, I take all that anger and emotion and I put it into my dance. Thank you for everything that you do and help me with, especially Sharath Kumar, because she does all of my research and really finds a whole lot of answers to help me, and she never stops helping.
The only words I can say are thank you. From the bottom of our hearts and our family, thank you.